In this section, we are going to give an introduction about Linux. I know that many people who are going to attend or buy this course may not have an experience with Linux, and Linux may be new for them. And this will be a good opportunity for people to get familiar with Linux, because Linux is a very, very good operating system. And we are all using Linux, except in some cases we don't know. For instance, the Android platform that exists on our mobile, this is a Linux platform. The Apple iOS also, it's a Linux platform. So the objective of this section is to introduce Linux to you and to show you how easy it is to use Linux. For security, Linux distribution are very, very important. And you're going to notice that people who work in penetration testing, they usually are using Linux tools. Definitely in this course, we'll be using Linux and we'll be using Windows as well. But also Linux is an important asset to learn during this training. And besides the introductions, and I'm going to explain and to show you how to get familiar with Linux, I will also add some video with my lecture that will help you in case you need to know more about Linux. Now, before start explaining Linux and how Linux are different than Windows, I just need to tell you that what you need to learn about Linux when it comes to penetration testing is just how to use it. We don't need to learn about the operating system architecture, the Linux architecture, or how it works, or what is the kernel, or you don't need to go that deep. It's like Windows. A lot of people are using Windows, and they just know how to use it. They just know how to run application from Windows, but not necessarily they know how the operating system are communicated with the hardware. They don't necessarily know about the operating system kernel and so on. So the objective here is how to use Linux. On the previous section, I showed you how to download them and how to run them from a virtual machine. On this video, I'm going to go through the basic commands that you're going to need. But before going through the command, I just need to point about the main difference between Linux and Windows, which is the file structure. Now, in Windows, how do we save and arrange our file and folder? In Windows, what we do is that we are dividing our hard drive to different partitions, could be one or more, and then start creating folders. And inside folder, we just save the file. So you have drive, and then you have folder, and then you have file. And you can have for drive different names, C and D and E and so on. In Linux, it's kind of different. You have a fixed filing system. So all Linux has the same structure, not like Windows. Windows, you may find people putting the Windows folder on a specific drive and their other folder. So they now have a specific structure, while in Linux, it's very fixed. It's very specific. So in Linux, we have one main folder called the root. And this is a bigger one. And under this folder, we have some subfolder. And each subfolder holds a specific kind of file. Like for instance, we have a subfolder called etc. And etc include all the configuration files. So file like password file, like network configuration file, like graphical file, this will be held inside the etc. While bin, which is stand for binary, hold all the command line. So when you type, for instance, ls, when you type nano, when you type any command, how the operating system understands this command, it will go to this folder, and it will check the nano file that explain how to execute nano. So if someone accidentally delete a file from here, it will actually, no one will be able to use this command. And we're going to see that in a few seconds when we open the Linux machine. While the home folder will hold all the user home folder. So on this machine, if two users are using this machine, user A and user B, each one will have a subfolder here under their name where all the file, their file will be saved. So if user A are creating a Word document, it will be saved under home, under his folder. div will hold the devices and so on. So it's not about explaining the functionality of each folder. It's just to know that there is a specific structure, because you're going to need to understand that while you are navigating inside Linux. So you need to know that there is a major folder called root, and under that there is some specific folders, and each folder holds a specific kind of file. And you may have different level. Now, when you log in as a root, and root in Linux represents the administrator, then you're going to have access to everything. While when you log in as a user, then you log in to the user level, so you can only have access to the user level. You don't have access to the above folder. So user cannot access the etc, which holds the configuration, so he cannot change the configuration, and so on. Now, let me show you a Linux machine and how to start it. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to shut down this machine, and I'm going to start from the beginning. And we're going to open the VMware. And I'm going to start the gtrack. So when you start, after doing the previous task from the previous section, when you start a Linux machine, most of the Linux will start in the command line. Some of them will start graphical, but most of them will start on command line. So you're going to notice that all the commands that we'll be using during this training, it's like maybe 12 or 15 commands. So you will not do any effort to memorize a lot of command and a lot of syntax. It's just few commands that we'll be using during this course. And I did categorize them inside the presentation, but I just want to show you what I just explained in a real machine. So once any Linux start, it start, or most of the Linux start in a graphic, in a command line. Now I need to start the graphical interface. So I should just type start X. And by the way, I need to tell you that Linux is case sensitive. So when you write a command, make sure all the command should be written in a small letters. So if you write the same command in capital letter, it will not be executed. So just be careful while you're doing that. And it will start the graphical interface. Now I just first want to show you how it looks like. And then we are going to get back to our presentation. So it's a graphical interface. It's very similar to Windows, where you have computer, you have different icon on desktop, and you can add more. You have a taskbar, and you have the gtrack menu here, where all the items are there, but categorized. So gtrack here has all the penetration testing tool categorized, penetration, information gathering, vulnerability, and everything. While services has some services, like SQL and Apache and so on. Internet has all the browser, so if you need to browse anything. And setting system tools, it's like the control panel in Windows. So you feel free to navigate there. And then you can right click here, and you can open a terminal, or you can change the desktop. Very similar to Windows. Now let me start by showing you the structure that I just explained. So when we open my computer, you can see that it will ask you, or it will give you the location right now. But if I go there and I put the sign which represents the root, it will show you the folder that I just explained, the etc, that has all the configuration file, all the folder and file. We are going to have the binary that has all the command, so all the command will be here. We have the home and so on and so forth. So this is how the file system in any Linux look like. So let me open a terminal, and because we're going to test some command while we are doing that, and let me change the size for you. And so it will be more clear for you. Okay. So this is 12. So I'm going to just change the size of each one of those, and I can even change the color so it will be clear. So it's, as you can see, it's quite easy to use that, and you can navigate and you can discover that. So in the command line, we're going to use that in many ways and in many cases. So yes, we can use the tools, the graphical tools here, but also you need to have some common basics about Linux. So let's get back to our presentation and let's explain what exactly we need to be aware of. So the commands that you need to know the basic command. Like for instance, and by the way, I also going to add a document that include all the commands that you're going to need in Linux. So you don't have to worry about memorizing them. So for instance, to check the file where you are standing, ls. Ls, which list will show you the file. So you only have one folder by the name of desktop. But if I go to the root and we use the cd or change directory to go to the root and type ls, you can see the file on the root, which is the same folder that I just explained. So ls, it's for browsing the file. And you still can do that from the command line. You have also a command called pwd, which is print working directory, where exactly we are standing right now. So if you type pwd, it will tell you right now you are on the root. Okay, I need to go to a folder called etc. So I should type cd etc, change directory etc. And now if I type pwd, he's going to tell you you are inside etc. So if I type ls right now, it will show you the, it will show me the file inside the etc. And by the way, the color of the file usually indicate its type. So this dark blue, those are folders, while the light blue, those are files, and so on. I need to get back to the root, so cd root. So I can navigate using cd and choosing the location where I need to go. This is if I need to do that from a command line. Also, another command, it's called who am I. It will show you I'm logged in with which account. Right now, I'm logged in with the root account, which is administrator account. This is the one with the higher privilege. So ls, this is one of the commands. We have the command that can be used to check the configuration, because actually this is very important, and mainly the network configuration. And we used to do that in Windows by typing ipconfig, but in Linux we type ifconfig. So it will show you the network adapter and what IP you are taking and all the network configuration. I know that the IP is showing above here, but still. Then we have a comment called dhclient, and dhclient is for requesting another IP. So when you type dhclient, it will request a new IP. So if your machine didn't get an IP, you can do dhclient to request a new IP. So those are some of the basic command. What else do we need to know about, or what other command we need? Editor is very, very important to us, because from time to time we're going to need to open some file and do some modification and write some code and stuff like that. So you need to know how to modify a file, how to change a file. So there is a lot of editor, but I prefer one specific editor called Nano. So let me clear the screen, clear, and let's check the file. So assume that, let me go inside the etc, because a lot of files are there. So if I go there and I check the file and assume that I find a file called, let's take for instance, this one, zlibc. So we can type nano and the name of the file, zlib. And by the way, in Linux, one of the nice things that you can do, that you don't need to write the full file name. A lot of file will have a long name. So you just type like the first three letter and tab will continue the name for you. And I can open, and it will open the editor, and it will allow us to modify where you need to modify. And once I'm done, as you can see below, you can type on Control and X. So it will close the file and it will ask you, would you like to save? Definitely. For me, I will not, because this is a configuration file. So Nano Editor, it's a very, very important editor that you can use. But I still have some graphical editor if you are not feeling comfortable. So I can go here. I can go to the root, and in any folder I would like to go, etc, for instance, and I can open any of those files. Those are folders, the orange one are folders. So I can go here, for instance, and I can open the file and I can modify. So you can use the graphical one, it looks like a notepad, or use, I prefer the command line, but you know, they are the same. So it depends on you. And you can also even use the same Windows feature in dragging. So I can drag a file and drop it on the desktop, or drag from one folder to another. So you still can use most of the Windows function. So this is regarding the editor. Okay. Now the navigation command, which is CD, and the location, this is actually, we already went through that. Change directory will take you from one folder to another. We have another command, which is the CP, copy command. And I can do that, copy, for instance, and then I can put the source and destination. So assume that I need to copy this file that I was just working with, and I wanted to put it inside the binary folder. So I can type copy, but I have to specify the full path from the root, from etc, the file, which is zch, and the path. Okay, this file, and then I want to put this folder inside the root under the binary folder, and you can put that so it will be copied to the same name. So now if you go to the binary folder, let's go, let's check, you should find this weird file there. So copy can be used, you can drag and drop, which is much more easier, but I want to show you different options that you have. And if you open binary, you should find this file, which is, where is it? It should be at the end, because yeah, here you go. So it has been copied. We can use copy or move. We have a similar copy MV. This will move the file, it will not copy. So it's not that hard. And in this stage, what I want you to do is just open the Linux and know how to run the graphical interface and how to open a terminal. And while we are explaining the course, you'll be learning that, and you'll be doing that yourself. So you don't have to worry about that. Last thing that I want to point to, inside this video, which is Linux has a very, very good help and online support. So, and it's free, most of them are free. So let's clear the screen and let's go to the root. So for instance, if you need to use a command like nano, but you don't know how to use it, you just type --help, and it will show you how to use it and any switch related to it and a usage of the command and so on. So you can use that as well if you forget, because you're going to notice that some of the command will have a lot of switches, --x, -s, -o. So sometimes you'll forget that. So don't worry about memorizing them. Just type --help after any command and it will explain to you how it should run. Besides, on the internet, you'll find a lot of websites. Just type any command, how to do that in Linux. A lot of resources are much more available than Windows resources. And additionally, I'm going to add with this video a couple of videos related to the Linux and some documents that will consider as a reference that include all the comments. But as I told you, you don't have to worry about Linux. It's very, very easy. And if you have any question about Linux, please post a question and I'll get back to you very fast, explaining that, how it's done, and if it's needed, I may create a video just for your question. So this will be it for it, for the Linux, and I want you to start the Linux. I want you to start, get familiar with before starting the course. And don't worry, if it's not that friendly, you'll get more familiar with when we start the next section. Thank you so much.